How to set up parental controls on iPad. The iPad has evolved into a formidable tool for both work and fun. The new features in iPad OS 15 have lately given the iPad even more power. Children, on the other hand, are among the iPad's most frequent users, as they utilize it to absorb entertainment in the form of games and television shows. However, as we all know, the online world is volatile, and without proper parental monitoring, children can quickly be exposed to things that they are not ready for. Fortunately, Apple has a comprehensive set of parental controls for the iPad that make it easy for parents to manage their children's exposure. Here's how to set up parental controls on iPad if you're a parent concerned about your child's safety while using their iPad. Set up parental controls on iPad. This guide explains how to get started with parental controls on the iPad and the numerous settings you may utilize to take advantage of its capabilities. Why do you need to use parental controls? While you may be hesitant to impose parental controls on your children's internet activities, there are various reasons to do so. For millions of people throughout the world, mobile entertainment has become a reliable platform. However, allowing your children unfettered access to the iPad leads to their spending an unhealthy amount of time on it. Enable screen time on iPad. Apple's screen time is a central way for you to get all the information you need about your device usage in one location. Once you've enabled it, you'll have access to all of the parental controls. Screen time on the iPad is simple to set up. Simply follow the steps following to get started. Open the Settings app on the iPad. Find and tap Screen Time on the sidebar. Tap Turn on Screen Time and a pop-up box will appear. Read the text shown and then press Continue. Depending on who you are enabling this for, select if this is your iPad or your child's. You will be met by a couple of informational pop-ups, including the option to set up downtime and app limits. You can choose to enable them right now. You can also change them after you finish the setup. Turn on downtime on iPad. Downtime is one of the most straightforward parental settings for the iPad. Only selected apps and phone calls will function during the interruption. You can set up the start time for the downtime and the end time. After you have selected the downtime, tap on Set Downtime. If you wish not to set up the downtime, tap on Not Now. Here you can also set up time limits for different apps' time. Let's say you want your kid to stay on social media and games only 1 hour. You can set up this here. Just select the category and then go to the bottom of the windows and tap on Set. Press Continue on the content and privacy box after reading the text. Now it is time to set up a passcode. This passcode will ensure you get access to the screen time and parental control settings of your child's iPad. Choose and insert a 4-digit passcode. Re-enter the passcode for verification and make sure to remember it or note it down somewhere. The next menu will ask for your Apple ID. This is in case if you forget your iPad parental control passcode and need to recover it. You can enter it or skip it according to your need. And you're done. Screen time has now been enabled on your iPad. You will have now access to all the features from the parental control. One of the most important features to check is content and privacy restrictions. On the iPad, children are very likely to consume stuff that is not intended for them. Tap Content and Privacy Restrictions from the screen time list. Find and toggle on content and privacy restrictions from the list available. Block app installs and purchases. The App Store is one of the most convenient methods for kids to acquire unfiltered content. Apart from not installing apps intended for them, children can also spend a lot of money by clicking on the appealing buy boxes. Furthermore, your children may begin app trials that you are unaware of. To avoid these issues, activate parental restrictions on the iPad to prevent the installation and uninstallation of any apps in the store, as well as purchases. Tap iTunes in an App Store Purchases. Here you will see a list of options that control the installing and deleting of apps along with purchases. You can also choose to set the iPad to ask for the passcode we made above. Tap Installing Apps and tap Don't Allow on the next screen. Repeat the same with every setting you wish to turn on or off. You're all set up. The amazing part here is, instead of blocking every purchase specifically, the iPad just hides the entire App Store. So the next time you want to hand the iPad over to your kids without the risk of any extra purchases or exposure, turn this parental control setting for the iPad on. Turn off explicit content. The explicit content your child can consume can range from music playback to even books they might read. You can choose to turn off explicit content on the iPad so your child only sees clean content. Here you can see various options that you can enable to restrict your child's access. We will focus on music and books. Tap Music, Podcasts, News, and Workouts. Simply choose Clean instead of Explicit, and you're done. Now tap on Back button. Filter website content. There is a lot of questionable and nasty stuff on the internet. Allowing your children to visit any website is a dangerous behavior that parents should avoid. You may rapidly choose filters accessible on the iPad's parental settings and even add your own unique websites using a simple setting. Find and tap Web Content from the list. Here you will see three filters that can either give kids full unrestricted access or only limit adult websites. Choosing only allowed websites also shows a pre-made list of kid-friendly websites you can let your children enjoy. If you want to grant or prohibit access to a specific website, tap the Add Website option or choose any of the other ones. You're all set. The iPad will now monitor website activity depending on the setting you have chosen and will act accordingly. Game Center Settings. Apple's Game Center is a gaming hub that allows players to socialize through multiplayer matches, achievements, leaderboards, and more. The Game Center serves as a handy tool when trying to game on the iPad. If you're currently trying to limit your child's online gaming activity, the iPad Parental Controls feature a separate Game Center section where you can restrict specific settings. You can find this option also on Control and Privacy Restrictions. Scroll all the way down on the list of items available, and you will have all the settings marked under Game Center. You can choose to turn multiplayer games on or off, restrict your kid from adding friends. You can turn off screen recording if you're concerned about privacy. We will choose multiplayer games. The next page will show settings to either limit or completely turn off multiplayer games. Choose whichever you want and you're done. Depending on what settings you adjust, your child's Game Center will adjust accordingly. This is how you can set up parental control on your iPad. If you stayed until the end, please show your appreciation by liking the video. Also, leave us a comment down below and subscribe for more tech videos. Have a great day.